Thank you. Thank you, Vicky, and people on the dais. Very nice listening to the conversations today. Would have been even nicer with Shri Abhay Damleji. I'm sure he's on his way. And even nicer if the minister would have been here. Having said that, very valid suggestions for the corporates and for us as we begin this time a little late the observation of the safety week, road safety week, and we were here just about a few months ago, I guess, when we were doing the annual conference on the road safety. My previous speaker was gifted by a few more inches, so there's a stool here so I can stand on it. Thank you so much. So now I have a little bit more time in closing. So while in my closing, I might make some comments on the things what we have been doing, and for knowledge of the team here, because we felt last time when we met, and I see some similar faces here, that we are responsible to come back to you with what we are trying to do as corporates. And it should not be just every time starting from the very beginning and saying that there are so many deaths, let's do something about it. So there have been some work which has happened, and especially for Pandaji, what we have been trying to do in FICCI with this road safety initiative, that corporates have come together and trying to put their minds and hearts into it, is that we are trying to do four things, and we've just begun, so I don't have a report in terms of what milestones we have already achieved, but we have begun four different verticals of work. First is mobility and analytics. Mobility is a very big part of road safety, and also even more important, because now people are using mobile phones while driving on the road, or even while jaywalking or walking by the roadside and getting hit. Things which you used to see in the YouTube as to how can a guy fall off the cliff while looking at his mobile phone is happening in India as well. So that is the kind of distraction people have, and the attention deficit which leads to accidents. But mobility also is important from point of view of how you can change behavior patterns. And I'll give you one example of what got discussed in our committee meeting last time, is that imagine if the Google Maps that has brought you here, how many of you came here using Google Maps? Can I see a raise of hands, please? So at least 50%, including me, I come here every week, courtesy Sumit, for some reason or the other, in some function or the other. So we use Google Maps, right? And therefore we know, or at least somebody knows, Google knows how rash we are. Can we have a factor of our rash driving using Google Maps? It's very simple, right? They do so much of algorithm. Can they not deliver you your algorithm of how rash you are on the road? Imagine what Google can do to you. So ask Google how rash you are. When you ask Google what Google can do, ask Google how rash you are. And can Google go back and link up with your Aadhaar card? Because Google has your Aadhaar card, you like it or not. And can that be linked to your insurance? How much premium you'll pay? You have not had an accident yet. I'm exactly going to the Freakonomics example which was given by Pandaji here, that you stop the smallest of incidents, the big ones will not happen. Just link these four things up together and build artificial intelligence around it and big learning machine data. No. Simple. So, is it the lack of detailing or lack of effort or lack of thinking which is coming from somewhere or not coming from somewhere? Now we hear the minister talking about so sensitivity that not wearing a helmet is almost like atmahatya. That's what we hear on the FM, right? We can go tweak a little bit deeper, dig a little bit deeper. There is so much of work, matter of work, and which can happen just by following one thing, which is Google telling you, like Sybil tells you your score, financial scorecard. Google tells you your rashness scorecard on Indian roads. You drive, you came here, you were rushed, and Google knows it. Right? So that's one example we can do, and probably we will end up doing it in the next 9 months that we are, as committee members, probably you will have something like that by the end of the 9 months. Second is education, and Mr. talked about the education. Let me say this to Pandaji that probably we do millions, if not billion, but we'll do millions of hours of training of our drivers who are on the road as corporates. If we add up all the corporates put together for road safety, we put a lot of money and time behind road safety for our drivers. And we don't see that on the other side. It is not the citizen effort, but it is corporate effort, because corporate, as you rightly said, is disciplined to do that activity. It has to report back to their accidents and the ripple effect they had in the economies that they operate. So we do that, but there is a small recommendation. And this ties up to Mr. Tuhin's very articulate opening, which he talked about sensitizing through stories. And Mr. Tuhin, imagine if there was the example which was also mentioned by I think you or Mr. Panda, that a girl child talking her story of what has been her experience of her father while he has been truck driving on the countryside, and people who have got affected by the accidents are the people who normally will be sitting here. How many of you had a near or dear one having met with not a fatal but at least an accident? A lot of you. Is that the reason of you being here? Can you raise hands? Is that the reason of you being here? Is that the reason of you being in the business of road safety or in the so-called work of road safety? Many of you are. So I sense that those are the people who start coming into getting attached to something like this. And it's extremely important. So again, going one level below of not having it, or not creating a situation where somebody dies on the road. We've seen a lot of statistics. Imagine if the children speak to their parents on almost everyday basis that come home safe, dad or mother, whatever, come home safe. And this small book here is the first month's creation of this committee, where 30-40 corporates put together have combined all their knowledge of educating school children, rather sensitizing the school children to sensitize their parents. And my humble request to Tuhin, as who is part of the advisory to Mr. Gadkari, is that can it be introduced as a formal education for children from class 6 to class 8? We've been talking about it for last 1 year, and we will create more and more documentation to prove that today's context, children are the best educators for their parents in terms of creating sensitivity. So that is one of a very, very big opportunity. And we will like to definitely request Minister and Mr. Abhidhamleji and Tuhin to take this thing up through the education route. We will request to bring in the NCRT this kind of a program. And I believe that some states have already started doing it, more from voluntary reasons, but it has already begun. Last but not the least, we heard a lot of data in terms of 3% GDP loss and 2% of national highways contributing to 30% of the road accidents. It's it's not a great number to talk about, but it is very evident because national highways are the fastest roads, and therefore with the poorest vehicles and the fleet on the fastest road, you will definitely lead to an accident. My question now is that we have done so much of analytics of the of our road safety data across the country. We talked about Pareto. Can we see a Pareto of black spots in the country? Those are the black spots where 80% people die. We know about it. We see those black spots on the highways. You can't see it, but a police report will have it. A Google report will have it. A report from the association or whatever who's managing all the deaths and hospitals definitely will have it. Those are the places where again and again the same accidents do happen. Where is the Pareto of that in Morth? Does Morth have all the information? I'm sure they have. National Highway Authority and Morth will have a lot of information of at least last 10 years where these 30% fatal accidents have happened. Is it because of the road construction? Is it because of the road infrastructure? Is it because of some technical issues on the highway itself that has led to not one, but multiple accidents exactly at the same spot? And that is what the Pareto should look for. And at corporate, what we are trying to do is, we are trying to collate, now for the governments, which is probably not something which we'll do it very optimally, but the same thing a government can do at a central level, to bring all the black spots from all the companies, from all the data that we have. We're also trying to do, and the next session we'll talk about it, journey risk management, where all the journeys which are mapped are brought in together from all the corporates into one repository, and the Map My India will put it together into one database, and we'll hand over that to Morth to take that thing forward. My request would be to really collaborate in this space, because you can hear the passion of corporate and you can hear the systems and the discipline, and probably we will be able to do a good fine job out of it. When we talk about tobacco and the related deaths of tobacco, and people see it whether they like or not, the gruesome things that happen to human body when you eat and have tobacco. And you see it in the movie halls. Every time you go to see the movie, you see that, right? Do you see it? You don't like to see it, but you see it, right? You may not be a smoker, but you still have to see it. That is not the number one disease in the country. The number one disease in the country is road accident. And we don't see that in the theaters. Why don't we not see it in the theaters? Why don't we not have a 2-minute video on road safety in the theaters, mandatorily for all the theaters in the country, for every show that you want to like to see? So there are a few things the corporates can do, and we are doing. These are the 4 things that we are doing. And my request to Minister Sahab and Pandaji is that let's take the step forward and do something about it in a very analytical way. We talk about cultural change, which can come through students. And that is the mainstream, not on the fringe. We can talk about analytics, which can come through Google, and we can talk about education, which can come through students and us put together, and real work which can happen through Morth, SIAM, and automobile associations via mapping of the black spots and everything else. So at the end, thank you very much for this session, really enlightening in terms of the information and suggestions which have come. One thing which I am taking back as part of what corporates can do, Pandaji, is that the commonality of a first aid response training program which corporates can put together. There is something called 108, but that's not good enough, I think, and corporates have a larger role to play in that space. But let me assure you, sir, that we are taking this road safety week program and training program to all the members of the corporates who are associated with this committee today, But not only that, I'm requesting Sumit and Mr. Chinoy to take this program to all FICCI members, which could be a couple of thousand members, I guess, who can run the same program, and we can come and assist you. So thank you very much.